Hi guys, you're joining me on a beautiful January morning here in the UK. I'm in the 308 and I haven't fixed it. What I have found is a little cheat. With the airbox off and a little squirt of Easy Start, she seems to fire up fine. Now I've got her started, take her out, warm her up, get her back into the garage and re-perform the compression test. Once I've done that, then I can actually start stripping those carburettors. Still a little bit nervous about doing that because I've not worked on Weber carbs before. But what's the worst that can happen? Back in the garage, and with a warm engine, I've re-performed the compression tests, and I'm pleased to say that cylinder 3 isn't reading lower than it was before. They all seem to be within 10% of each other, which I think is fine, but overall I think they're a little bit lower than they should be, or certainly lower than I was expecting. So I'll probably give Mike at QV a call and just run through it with him, as he knows this car and he certainly knows his carbureted Ferraris.
A Weber carburetors, got four of them, they're all linked together. First of all, we've got the choke cable running through here, which is not something I use very often, if I'm honest. They're linked together here and at the back here, and then the cable runs front to back there, so you can see when I move that, you've got all that operation there. Accelerator cable comes in on the side, cable is connected there and there, so that's connected in front and back, and then side to side we've got these cables running here as well. So you see, if I move the accelerator, you can see everything moves harmoniously. To get the carb off, I have got one, two, and then three, four nuts to get each one out. I must be doing something wrong here. I can undo three of those retaining nuts from the rear two carburettors, but that fourth one, the one that sits underneath the float bowl, I just can't get in there at all. I'm just, a lot harder than I was expecting. So I need to go away and do a bit more research and see if I can find anything on the forums.
Now, having a quick look online, I couldn't find any videos, but I did see a single comment on one of the forums about the stubby spanners and crow's feet spanners. So I've ordered a set of those, even though I've never heard of them before. I've done the trick. I managed to get the first carburetor off. Here it is, semi-stripped down. Also, I've had a next day delivery from the lovely guys at Superformance, which included a service kit for four carburetors and base plates as well. So no excuses now, just need a crack on.
Four carburetors are now off the car, and you can see these three are quite mucky, in need of a good clean up. But now they're off, they're easier to get to. The fourth one is here in component form. So I've got everything off, starting to do the clean up. So now it's a case of putting it all back together again.
That's it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. We've got all the carburetors out now. The first one stripped down, started doing the cleanup on that. So the next video, obviously, I'm going to start putting that back together again. And then I've got to do the same with the other three. So if you want to see what happens there, then please subscribe up over here. And if you enjoyed the video, please give me a thumbs up. But until next time, thanks for watching. Take care.